point on this little mark or the stream here, you've got a bit of a flow of fresh water going out. It's where we're going to be casting over to get some flounders. Hopefully. Mainly ragworm's going to be our main bait today. We've got a little bit of lugworm on us. Yeah, good morning, guys. So we're down here at Hillhead, or the little bit of stream. There's a little bit of a stream behind me. Hoping for a couple of flounders, maybe a bass. You know, anything's possible. There's a bit of lugworm, a bit of frozen lug. I've got acquired from Rover's Tackle. Big good stuff. So the rig what I'm using is a two up, one down, flapper style rig. I'll show you how I'm baiting up. A little bit of black lug up like that and tip it off two little worms on this hook. Got his head hurt, a bit of towel wriggling. Much how I'm going to be fishing. This one I'm using the cocktail, but I'm just using a plain rag. You know, sometimes I'd say for this worm it's not ideal, but you know, I'll just fish this worm straight through. Tend to, when I'm hooking bigger worms, bring it near around out to the towel there. Well, that's snapped anyway, but do you see what I mean? Like the hook's there, kind of straight up, straight thread through. Two baits done. Well, ideally, I would have been out digging myself and getting some proper small worm, but you know, make do with what we got, hopefully the flounders. So mainly on this one I'm gonna, with the lug, I tend to, it's not the old best black lug in the world, but twist them around, twist. I don't thread these on, these blacks like this. A little bit like that, a little bit of towel can go. Pull that out of the shank of the hook so you've got a bit at the top. Got yourself two small worms, one small worm. I'm fishing the size two there. Perfect. So much movements there. When I cast this, I'm going to be putting, just don't get it into the seawater, it toughens up the towels, stopping flying off. Nice little gentle cast, about 30 yards out. Our first one in at 8:15. And I've already got a boat, guys. Which is, as soon as I cast that out, it was knocking over. I've already got a fish on, but I'll leave it, get another rod baited up. Yeah, so I'm going to snap a little bit off, just like that, a couple of inches. Get a rook. And I'll pop him in, twist it, pop, twist. Like that. That particular hook, I'm just going to fish it a little bit lug that way. It's all about trial and error, this sort of style of fishing. You know, sometimes they'll take just a little section of ragworm like this. Grab hold of them. And sometimes just take a little section of worm. And sometimes they'll just feed on maddies.
You get six or seven little maddies on there, which I ain't got any, but so we do what we can with what we've got. No reason why we shouldn't get a fish, so we've got to do a bit of lug. A bit of lug on this bottom one. A dinky bit like that. Comes off your fingers. Yeah, so we go, little twist around, twist. Pull that up. Ragworm, feed them up. Feed them right up. They're all out to the tail. Keep going, feeding up, feeding up, feeding up. About there. Hook points just there. Bait's there. Let's get this one out.
Yeah, guys, so what you want to do is keep your bait wrapped up. We cast now 20 minutes at a time. 20 minutes, bring it in, check our bait. If there's nothing on there, clean it off and start again. Drop your time down to 15 minutes, 10 minutes. So you've already had a bite on the first rod. Make sure, definitely in conditions like this, it's raining, with a bit of rain, it'll kill your worm in a second. So make sure you wrap it up, keep it in the dry, out of the way.
31. You say this one, the first one might have cast out, but I showed you how to bait up.
We're slamming over a couple of times, so we should have a flounder on them, open. But I'm being patient. There's a lot of you guys should do, we definitely need flounder fish, and just wait. Leave it. I've got three baits out there, I've got three hooks on that particular rod. Now if there is a couple of fish around, you know, well, catch one at a time and you can catch three at a time. We cast out at 15:15, so I'm going to give it another 4 minutes, have a cigarette, sit on my hands and see what we got.
There you go, guys, nice little solent shoal bass, pristine condition, lovely hook, so he's going to return brilliant. He just changed his mind when he see me pull the camera out. He's just whipped his net up as well. No more, what, 200-300 yards off the shore there? He's not off far at all, cheeky fuck. set off three rods, right? There's one way up there, just free at a flapper. And I've just picked up a Thornback. Very happy. What can I say? What an amazing couple of weeks fishing I've had. The female. You know, don't get no better than this, does it, lads? Picked him up on a bit of ragworm. They're 44 across the wing, so pulling itself up. It's a good 44 anyway. Right, lads, just had another little shoaly up here. I'm going to try to bomb a disorder if I can and get him back. It turned out to be a right little session. Probably going to be last cast now because I'm running out of bait. So, but well worth a go. Definitely come up here. Yeah, alright guys, what a cracking little session we've had. A nice Thornback ray out, loads of shoalies, couple of small ones obviously, but what a nice day's fishing. I've had absolute enough now, I'm soaked through as you can see. I'm going home to get myself a nice cup of tea. We place it into the impact part of the lead so that sits tight. Then I pinch it, just like that. And I get this other hook, I put it just into the cascade swivel.